marketing, there's email, there's word of mouth, all that kind of stuff. Whatever your source is, I'm just telling you guys, for us, about 70% is typically social media, and about 30% tends to come from referrals. So again, our goal is just to get 30 leads for the month. So one lead a day, that's the first step that we're talking about. So how do we do this? The first thing is being authentic. We don't need to spend much time on this. I think you guys know this. The only reason I put this slide up there is because I do see, unfortunately, a lot of fitness professionals, especially when it comes to lead acquisition and marketing, outsourcing a lot of it. I'm not a big fan of outsourcing a whole lot of your marketing. The reason being is because I feel like you have your own unique voice, and the person that you outsource to that builds the ads for you doesn't have that same voice as you. So it's hard to tell your story and have your voice if you're always outsourcing your marketing. So I believe if you have the processes internally to be able to do that, I'm a big fan of not doing that and being able to do it all in-house. You can. And the other thing with this is just finding out what's your differentiator. How do you differentiate yourself from the market? And what's your biggest differentiating factor? So the first thing with marketing, and we're going to spend, of these five steps, we're going to spend the most time today on the marketing aspect of it, just because for me personally, that's been the most influential, the most important thing I've learned, is how to do the marketing and lead acquisition. Because really, at the end of the day, retention's important, sales important, but you got to be able to get people in the door if you're trying to make money and if you're trying to successfully generate revenue and grow, right? So that's what we're going to spend the most time on today. So the first thing is, everybody always starts like, I don't know what to post. Like, I have no idea what to post on social media. What should I do? So for me and our team, the biggest thing that we've implemented is implementing a game plan and just having a plan for every day of the week, right? And I'll show you guys some examples here in a sec, but it might look like, hey, every Monday, we're just going to do a testimonial video, right? Every Tuesday, we're going to do a fit tip video. Every Wednesday, we're going to do a recipe blog. And I have these on the next slide, so you guys don't have to write down those examples yet. But the big take home with this is implementing a plan. You have to have a plan of action so that you're not waking up in the morning being like, man, what the heck am I going to post today? It's a lot easier to manage if, say, you know, every Monday I'm going to post this, every Tuesday I'm going to post this. It doesn't have to be the exact same post, but you have a theme of that post. Like, every Monday I'm going to do this style of post. It makes it a lot easier than just waking up in the morning and trying to figure out what you're going to do, right? So these are just some examples. I don't like using text a lot on slides, but I wanted to give you guys some examples because depending on where you're at in your social media, some of you guys might be brand new. If you're brand new to having a posting system, these are just some things that have worked really well for us. Again, this is more from the fitness side of things, so it might be a little different for you guys that are in massage, medical, but you get the idea, at least gives you an idea. So we have our nutrition recipe blogs. Those are really simple. My operations manager does it, and it's just a recipe, which when we first did it, I was like, there's no way anybody's gonna care about these recipes. But we get the most clicks on any of our social media stuff off of our recipes, which is pretty crazy. Then we have video testimonials. I'll show you guys an example of that in a sec. We have a fit tip video. I'm a big proponent of making my team and my staff shoot videos, get comfortable being on camera, establishing themselves as experts. So we have every meeting we have, the first meeting of the month, all of our coaches shoot either one or two fit tip videos that we're gonna post later throughout the month. Our 30-day evergreen ad, that'll make more sense in a sec. That's just like our standard evergreen ad that's running on Facebook that's for our 30-day trial. It's made through Ads Manager, it's not a content post. Same thing with the 6-week transformation, we usually run those quarterly. We have a fixed testimonial, and you guys will see examples of all these in a sec, so don't worry about necessarily seeing exactly what they are right now. But the fixed testimonial is just lives on our website. We call it People of KE or People of Cutting Edge, and it's just these still testimonials telling our clients' stories. Lives on our website. Then there's the lead magnet. This is a great one for what Christoph was talking about being able to get people's emails. So it's just like a download our top 5 nutrition myths, or if you're a golfer, maybe download my top 5 exercises to increase rotational power. Whatever it is, people overthink it. It should take you like a half an hour to create these little ebooks. They're nothing like crazy. It's literally just like 5 exercises, have the pictures, have a quick description. But those get a lot of traction. People want to download that stuff. They want quick fixes, unfortunately, even though that might even not be what you believe in. You're not going to probably tell your clients like, hey, I have these magic 5 exercises. But online, if you can have a PDF that people can download, that generates a lot of traction. People really want to see that kind of stuff. And then you get their email, and then you nurture them from there as far as the sales and that process goes. And then we have an exercise blog post as well. So first of all, I'll give you guys an example of, hopefully the sound works on this. This is our video testimonial. So we shoot these in the gym. They're just under a minute, so they fit on Instagram. And all it is we have 4 questions that we always ask, and you'll hear those questions going here. And then it's just going back and forth basically between her working out so people actually see her in the gym and then her just sitting down answering these questions. They're very straightforward, but the biggest mistake I see coaches that I consult with make is they make all of their social media about them and the cool exercises they do, which, I mean, if we're being honest, nobody gives a shit about the exercises that you do. Nobody cares that you can deadlift X amount. Nobody cares about the exercise you're doing. You have to be able to tell your client's story or let them tell the story for you. So that's where testimonials are very powerful, and they're going to get you a lot more traction and attract the right type of clients versus you, you know, doing a workout selfie or doing something that you guys are doing in the gym. So here's an example of it. I'll let this run real quick just so you guys can see it. Hopefully the sound, I think the sound's on.
I'm getting a lot stronger. When I